asking the most important question of the night. Do you have to be bald to look totally awesome in a kilt?
Yes.
No, but it helps.
It helps a lot.
Yeah.
Yep.
Us and Bruce Willis. No, actually, the reason I hired mostly bald guys is to be my doppelgangers in case I die.
Yep.
Or I want to throw somebody off my trail. I will put Eric forth and say, Tender B. No. Salespeople come to the shop soliciting for, you know, telephone or, you know, hey, can we see your Pico bill? We want to tell you all about the energy savings. No. Get out. Eric, you be the mean guy today.
Okay.
Hey, if it works for The Rock, it works for us.
Yeah. It's we have limited hairstyle options. It's basically this or a skullet. And I've decided to spare you that visual and just go with this.
I'm imagining you in a Celtic monk's tonsure now with the Celtic monks invented the mullet, basically. So
or ponytail
with
a man bun? I'll just flip it up top, like a reverse comb over, all the way up to the front from the back.
Yep. Well, the ancient Highland Warriors did that. They did that. They had a skull, but they flipped the hair up onto their heads as helmet padding. You see, that's...
It was actually to confuse their enemies, because they would like talk like this.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. And say, no, you're not looking for me. You're looking for Angus. He's got the hair like this. That gets back to what we're saying about the skin dew. You know, there's so much BS out there. So many stories. You really got to be careful and trust your resources. But the bald thing is absolutely freaking true. Yeah.
Yeah.
My great-great-grandfather was bald. He told me it's traditional to be bald. Anything else?